Welcome. In this video, we're going to solve a two-part problem. Now, the first part of this problem is very much in the algebra side of the course. We're going to find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of this matrix A. And for the second part, well, we're going to steal the problem from the calculus side of the course and solve it using our algebraic techniques. So, firstly, let's get this first part done. So the eigenvalues are the solution to the characteristic equation. And the characteristic equation is the determinant of A minus lambda I is equal to zero. So if we calculate that, that is the determinant of 2 minus lambda 3, 1, 4 minus lambda. If you do this calculation, you'll end up with lambda squared minus 6 lambda plus 5. And, well, the solutions to this are not too hard to see, because we can just factor it as lambda minus 1 lambda minus 5. And so, looking at this, of course, the characteristic equation is all of this equal to 0. And the solutions to this equation are quite obvious. They're given by lambda 1 is equal to 1, and lambda 2 is equal to 5. So we found our eigenvalues. Now let's find the corresponding eigenvectors. So let's try and find the eigenvector for our first eigenvalue, lambda 1 equals 1. So for lambda 1 equals 1, what we need to solve is the equation A minus I times our vector is equal to 0. And what is this as an augmented matrix? Well, this is just the system of equations 1, 3, 1, 3 augmented with 0, 0. And we can easily row reduce that. Let's just take row 2 and make it row 2 minus row 1. So that is the matrix 1, 3, 0, 0, 0, 0. Now we can back substitute this. So let's set the second component. I'll say V2 equal to a parameter T. And when we solve this, we get V1 is equal to minus 3 times T. So let's put this into a vector. So our eigen vector is going to be T times the vector minus 3, 1. Although this isn't the complete story, because eigenvectors are never zero vectors, so I should restrict myself to the case t not equal to 0. Now let's find our second eigenvector. So for lambda 2 equal to 5, you have to solve the equation a minus 5i times our vector is 0. So again, let's take this and make an augmented matrix out of it. So this will be the matrix minus 3, 3, 1, minus 1, augmented with 0, 0. Again, this is quite easy to solve. Let's just do one row reduction. So row 2 is equal to row 2 plus a third row 1. And if we do that, we get the matrix minus 3, 3, 0, 0, augmented with 0, 0. And back substituting, let's set the second component of our vector equal to a parameter. So in this case, I'm going to make it the parameter s. And if we solve for the first component, we get v1 is equal, well, it's also equal to s. So that gives us our second eigenvector, which I'll call u, is s times the vector 1, 1. And again, vectors, eigenvectors are non-zero vectors. So let's restrict ourselves to the case where s is non-zero. So for the second part of this question, we're going to solve a calculus problem. And we're not coming to this calculus problem unarmed. We're actually given that this matrix A has eigenvalues 5 and 1, and with respective eigenvectors, given over here. But how does this help us? How do we relate this matrix to these equations? Well, if you take a look at these equations, they can be written in the following form. So let's take the derivative of the vector containing x and y. Well, you can actually just write that as the matrix 2, 3, 1, 4 times the vector containing x and y. That is, it is just the matrix A times x, y. And now, problems of this form are quite easy to solve since we know the eigenvectors and eigenvalues of this matrix. They are just given by x, y is equal to a constant, I'm going to call it alpha, times the vector, the first eigenvector, 1, 1, and the exponential of the first eigenvalue times t. And we have a second part, which is the second eigenvector times the exponential e to the t. So the second eigenvalue times t. And this is the general solution for arbitrary constants alpha and beta. And thank you for watching.